Hi guys, Ali here, your personal technical trainer. In this video, we're going to take a look at some of the new features that has been released with Windows 11 22H2. Customizing the start menu is now a lot more easier. If you look into your start menu, there are three rows of pinned applications. First of all, you can now group the applications together and name that group something you like. Also, if you like, you can change the number of rows for the pinned applications and the recommendations. For that, you need to go to the settings, select the personalization, and start menu. Now you have the option to select between the more pins, default layout, or more recommendations. You can also see there are three toggles that you can decide which one suits your needs. Also, if you notice to the start menu, between the profile picture and the shutdown button, there is a lot of unused space which we can use it. Again, in your start menu personalization and the folders icon, you can decide what other options you would like to see there. For example, if you like to see the settings, document folder, video folder, and maybe your downloads, you just need to toggle them turned on, and those icons would be here. And finally, Microsoft has listened. File Explorer now has tabs. If you do not see this plus icon on your File Explorer, click the link on top right corner of your screen to watch the video on how to enable tabs for File Explorer. With this new feature, you can open multiple tabs in the same window. Let's say I would like to go ahead and browse my desktop, and at the same time, I would like to go ahead and open up my C drive, and at the same time, go and open up my documents. Also, the other thing that you notice here is that you have two more sections, favorites and the recent files. It shows you the files that have been opened recently. And if you like, you can right click on any of these files and add them to your favorites. So those files would always be available at your fingertips. If you like to close one specific tab, you just right click on tab and close the tab. You have two other options as well. You can close all other tabs except the one that you selected, or you can select all the tabs to the right of the tab that you have selected. So if I select this option, it will close all the other tabs that I have opened after this one. There is a new champion in town. Yes, Windows 11 has added a fully functional video editing software. You just need to go to Start menu, search for ClipChamp, and run that application. ClipChamp is a fully functional video editing software. If you are a fan of creating your own videos, even in the free version, it gives you a lot of functionalities and tools that are helpful. You can just go ahead, create your own video, use their own templates, allows you to capture your screen and also your webcam at the same time. There will be a video coming out on how to use ClipChamp, so make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified when the new videos comes out. There is a new security feature as well, Smart App Control. If you go to the settings, search for Smart App Control, you can see all the settings related to Smart App Control settings. By default, this application feature is in evaluation mode, which you can turn on or turn off. The downside to this security feature is that you cannot receive it as an update. When you update your Windows to Windows 22H2, it comes as turned off and you won't be able to enable it. You have to do a full reinstall. There are solutions to bypass these limitations, which I'm gonna put in the description, a link to the video that completely explains how to bypass these limitations. If you'd like to learn more about the Smart App Control, click on the link on top of the screen and watch the video for Smart App Control. Smart App Control basically controls the applications that you're trying to install on your computer. If it identifies them as an untrusted or an unsafe application, it will prevent the application from installation. This is technically here to keep us safe. Widgets are now even easier to access. They are on your taskbar. If you're a fan of reading articles or following the news, you have your widgets. You can customize what you would like to see, what you don't like to see, and you can react to some of the articles. Windows Photos have received some improvements as well. One of the most important improvements that Microsoft is talking about is opening two pictures side by side. In order to do that, open your first picture, and on the film strip down below, you can select the other picture that you would like to see and compare those two pictures together. Windows Accessibility have received quite a few improvements as well. If you go to the Start menu, select the Settings, Accessibility, and selecting Narrator, you see that there is an option for natural voices. You can now download the new natural voices to sound a little bit more natural. Let's try and see how do they sound.
Hello, my name is Guy. I am a high-quality speech voice that you can use for your screen reading needs with Narrator.
You can install that voice and use it. On a shortcut, if you want to quickly enable the narrator, you can go here on the right bottom corner of your Windows and select Accessibility, select which features you would like to enable. Task Manager has received major upgrades as well. If you open up the Task Manager by pressing Ctrl+Shift+Escape on your keyboard, you can see the older version of Task Manager was very outdated. But if you look at the newer version of the Task Manager, we see that they have added a run new task on every single page that we go. So now it's easier for us when we're dealing with the Task Manager to run a new applications. The other advantage that you can see here is that the information that you receive inside the Task Manager is a little bit more straightforward. It's more streamlined. You can easily identify the root of the problems that you might be looking into. The other advantage that I can see is the side menu has changed as well. If you go to the Processes tab, there is a new feature which allows you to show which processes have been put on pause to save the battery and processing power. You might also see an echo icon, which means that those applications are running in efficiency mode. You can now look at the world's most beautiful landscapes right from your desktop, one picture at a time. You just need to right-click on your desktop, select Personalization, and select Background. From here, select the Windows Spotlight, which shows one picture every day. If you're interested to read about that picture, there is an icon on the right top corner of your screen, which gives you information about that picture. You can also right-click on that icon and switch to the next picture if you wish to. Snap layout is now a lot easier. Previously, you could hover your mouse over this maximize button and you could see the options available to you. But right now, in the Windows 11 22H2, if you select your open window, you see this black bar appearing on the top. And by hovering your mouse on any of these positions, you can decide where you would like to snap windows. Also, if you're a fan of using shortcuts, you can use the Windows key and arrows to decide how would you like to snap your window. You can now use focus setting inside your Windows clock application. You only need to open the clock application, select the focus settings, and the amount of minutes that you would like to focus. You will even have the option to skip breaks. If you don't do so, the moment you start the focus session, it will block all the notifications, all the badges, and everything that can distract you. You can also define what tasks would you like to do. You can also exit out of this one and focus on the task that you would like to complete. Also, you can keep track of your progress on how many days you've been successful on assigning a time and dedicating that time to your focus. To get the latest version of Windows installed on your computer, if you haven't received it yet, go to your Start menu, Settings, and Windows Update. From the Windows Update page, just check for the updates and install all the latest updates that are available for you. Keep in mind, there are times that you might not receive the updates on day one. It might take a few days or sometimes a week before your computer receives that update. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Thank you for watching and hope to see you on the next video.